Hello friends, this is Gayatri Pawar from KKWA College of Agribusiness Management, Nasik. Today we will study price policies in India. So what does agricultural price policy exactly means and what does it provide? So agricultural price policy provides necessary incentives to the farmers for raising their agricultural output through modernization of the sectors. Every year, the government announces certain schemes for the betterment of the farmer. Agricultural price policy accounts for various economic factors such as rates and quality of economic growth, which has been consequently ensured the appropriate allocation of resources, capital formation, and fair trade terms. Now, what is appropriate allocation of resources? So, in economics, resource allocation is nothing but the assignment of available resources to various uses. In the context of an economy, resources can be allocated by various means such as markets or central planning. So what is capital formation? Capital formation is a term which is used to describe the net capital accumulation during an accounting period for a particular country. The term refers to the additions of capital stock such as equipment, tools, transportation, assets, and electricity. Fair trade terms. Fair trade is a trading partnership based on dialogue, transparency, and respect that seeks greater equity in. Now, what is the need of agriculture price policies? First point, agricultural price fluctuates more violently than the industrial prices. Second, producer as well as consumer are suffered a lot because of this price fluctuation. Price fluctuations retard economic development of the nation. Fourth point, price fluctuation also affects the welfare of the customers. Fifth point, inflation affects low income groups as most of the goods are not in reach of the consumers. Now we will see the objectives of agricultural price policy. The major objective of the price policy is to safeguard farmers' interest and give necessary incentive to augment the agricultural production. The stability of agriculture price is essential since the higher agricultural prices affect purchasing power of the consumer, which implicates the demand for industrial goods. There are some broad objectives of agricultural price policy. First one, to set remunerative prices with a view to encourage higher investment and production in agriculture. Second point, to set appropriate prices so that the customers don't get adversely affected. Third point, agricultural prices should be such that the terms of trade between agriculture and non-agriculture sector are not adversely affected. Fourth point, to set prices in such manner so that the optimal crop mix can be achieved. Thus, theoretically, agriculture price policy, that is APP, accounts for various economic factors such as the rate and quality of economic growth in identifying and promoting the optimal crop mix. This consequently ensures appropriate allocation of resources, capital formation in the agricultural sector, and fair international term of trade. Features of agriculture price policy in India. First one is setting up institutions. Second is minimum support price. Third, protecting the customers or consumers. Fourth, fixation of maximum prices. Let us begin with the first point, that is setting up institutions. The Government of India has set up some institutions for the implementation of agricultural price policy in the country. And accordingly, the Agricultural Price Commission was set up in 1965, which announced the minimum support price, that is MSP, and procurement prices for the agricultural products. Later, in 1985, the name of this institution was changed into Agricultural Cost and Price Commission. Moreover, the Food Grains Policy Committee was appointed by the government in 1996, which also recommended various measures of price support. And FCI was set up in 1965 for making necessary procurement, storage and distribution of food grains. Later on in 1989 to 1990, total capital employed in FCI was to extend of rupees 5138 crore with its total storage capacity at 8 million tons. The corporation organizes the price of food grains at government determined prices and sell these food stocks through the network distribution system. Second feature of APP is minimum support price. The government fixes the minimum support prices of agricultural products like wheat, rice, maize, cotton, sugarcane, pulses, etc., etc., regularly for safeguarding the interest of farmers. The FCI also make their purchase of goods at the procurement prices so as to maintain a rational price of food grains on the interest of farmers. Accordingly, minimum support price, that is MSP, for food grains is fixed by the government, increased from rupees 388.26 per quintal in 2003 to 2004 to rupees 429.22 in 2007 and 8, and then to rupees 829.94 at average in 2012 to 2013. Third feature of agricultural price policy is protecting the consumers. In order to safeguard the interest of the consumer, the agricultural price policy distribution system has been made. Fourth feature of agricultural price policy is fixing the maximum prices. In order to have a control over the prices of the essential commodities, the government usually determines the maximum price of agricultural products so as to protect the general people from exorbitant rise in prices. Now we will see the important effects of agricultural price policy. They are as follows. First one, incentive to increase production. Second, increase in the level of income of farmers. Third one, change in cropping pattern. Fourth, benefit to consumers. Fifth, benefit to industries. And sixth one is price stability. Let us begin with the first point, that is first important effect of agriculture price policy, which is incentive to increase production. Agricultural price policy has been providing necessary incentive to the farmers for raising their agricultural output through modernization of the sector. The minimum support price should be determined effectively by the government, which will safeguard the interest of the farmers. Another important effect of agriculture price policy is it increases the level of income of farmers. The agriculture price policy provides necessary benefits to the farmers by providing necessary encouragement and incentives to raise their output and also by supporting its prices. All these have resulted in an increase in the level of income of farmers as well as their living standards. Another important effect of agriculture price policy is that it changes cropping pattern. Agriculture price policy has resulted in a considerable change in cropping pattern of Indian agriculture. The production of wheat and rice has increased considerably through the adoption of modern technique by getting necessary support from the government. But the production of pulses and oilseeds could not achieve any considerable change in the absence of such price support. Another effect of agriculture price policy that it benefits consumers. The policy has also resulted in considerable benefit to the consumer by supplying the essential agricultural commodities at reasonable price regularly. Another effect is that it benefits industrialists. The agricultural price policy has also benefited the agro industries of the country like sugar, cotton, textile, vegetable oil, etc., etc. By stabilizing the price of agricultural commodities, the policy has made provision for adequate quantity of raw materials for the agro-based industries of the country at reasonable prices. Price stability. The agricultural price policy has stabilized the prices of agricultural products to a large extent. It has become successful to contain the undue fluctuation of prices of agricultural products, which has created a favorable impact on both the consumer and the producers of the country. Now we will study market integration and types of market integration. Now, what does integration mean? Integration means a combination of business units that are separate but complementary to each other. I repeat, it means a combination of business units which are separate but are complementary to each other. When business units join hand to accomplish certain well-defined goals or objectives, it can be called as integration. Thus, market integration means a process which refers to the expansion of firms by consolidating, that is merging, additional marketing functions and activities under a single management. This definition is given by Coles-Ullal. Types of market integration. First one is horizontal integration. Second one is vertical integration and third one is conglomeration. This is an example of independent oil refineries coming under US oil company. Another example is McDonald's, which wanted to buy Burger King. Where a person expands into a field of selling that is similar to the one they are already in. Vertical integration. Now, what does vertical integration mean? Reduction of the number of middlemen or of a number of successive agencies found in marketing channels as the product moves from the farm to the consumer is called as vertical integration. It occurs when firm performs more than one activity in the sequence of marketing process. See, it is linking together of two or more functions in the marketing process within firm or under single ownership. Some organization such as supermarket or say cooperative store have developed, so it can be called as vertical integration. Vertically integrated types of business in some products wherein one concern handles the product by elimination two or more source in the marketing channel. And these agencies usually enter into the agreement with the producing firm for direct supply of produce or for the sale to consumer at a reasonable price. FCI, the Food Corporation of India, the farmer or agent goes to the farmers, sell through cooperatives and at fair price shops or commission agent near to the consumer. The corporation has succeeded in achieving vertical integration by passing intervening middlemen. Many of cooperative milk supply unions are yet another examples by extending loans to the farmer to a locality for the purchase of milk cattle, feeds and concentrate. These unions are assumed of milk supply from the farmers doorstep or from booth near to them. It is subdivided into two, which are discussed as follows. For example, meat industry buys all the functioning plants needed for running this meat industries, like as from cattle to slaughterhouse. Then the slaughter after the slaughtering of cattle, the meat is refrigerated in railroad cars or are stored in warehouses, that is cold storage. Then they are packed and then delivered, and then it is sold in a particular shop. It is subdivided into three types. First one is forward integration, second one is backward, and third one is balanced vertical integration. Now, what does forward integration mean? If a firm assumes another function of marketing which is closer to the consumption function, it is a case of forward integration, or it can be called as forward integration. For example, when a wholesaler assumes the function of retailing. Next, backward integration. It involves ownership or a combination of sources of supply. For example, when a processing firm assumes the function of assembling or purchasing the produce from the villages, it is called as backward integration. Third one is balanced vertical integration. This third type of vertical integration is nothing but a combination of the backward and the forward vertical integration. Third type of integration is conglomeration. A combination of agencies or activities not directly related to each other may, when it operates under a unified management. It can be termed as conglomeration. For example, Hindustan Unilever Limited and Delhi Cloth and General Mills, which produce cloth and vanaspati ghee, etc., etc., have combined together is a best example of conglomeration. There is one more example of agribusiness conglomerate. Here we can see food grain trade, food processing unit, retail chain, cloth mill, electronic goods and vanaspati products are manufactured or are sell under one roof, which can be called as agribusiness. And Hindustan Unilever, as discussed earlier, is the best example of conglomeration integration. Thank you, friends, for listening me. Do comment for any queries.